Born and brought up in Changanashiri. My education was from St. Bhagwan's High School and St. Bhagwan's College. For engineering, I went to Andhra after my civil engineering background. For a job opportunity, I came to Delhi in 1965. So the beginning period, I was supposed to work with a construction company. Almost 3 to 4 years I was out of Delhi. But my real life started in Delhi is in 1969. As a beginner, it is not that easy to establish in any profession as a businessman. My civil engineering background, working in different architect organizations, and fortunately, I have experience not only as a qualified commercial artist, national sculptor, a passionate photographer. This helped me to establish an organization such museums, interiors in the name of Philippos. It is known as Philippos Museum Interiors. The first project I got was Jawaharlal Nehru Planetarium. It is a very memorable experience. Since then, the journey was so smooth. I get into very, very nationally important project like National Museum of Natural History and innumerable projects, if I name it on my credit, Rashtrapati Museum, WWF Dehradun, Wild Institute of India, and Jim Corbett Park, Raja Dilip Singh Museum, Rani Lakshmi Museum, more than 32 museum I could do it in my span of life. And one important project which I executed was a 25,000 square foot area of Cuttack, that is in Orissa, Marine Museum of Orissa. That was really a task to me. It was a great successful project. In the meantime, I could work for many, many elite clients, of course, very prestigious clients, which I usually never highlighted, from Mrs. Gandhi to almost 6 to 7 prime ministers of India. Not as a full-time designer, but I could execute many works for them. It really gives me immense pleasure to remember and recollect it. To start a business as a museologist and doing museum projects, those days it was a very rare opportunity. We hardly get 1 or 2 projects in a year. So I sustained on this profession almost 40 years. So to get the economical balance, I started doing interior projects simultaneously. That given me financial success and stability. But my love was for art. So the background of sculpture, painting, photography and journalism, it was very much needed, particularly for this project. And last almost 10 years, the government of India had taken a lot of initiative and every state has surplus fund to do, undertake new projects on, especially museums. So for the younger states, it's a wonderful time. As a beginner, my life was not that easy, but I could manage it, I could establish it. Still, I have my own doubts. How people trusted me, they never questioned my integrity, given me a lot of love, regards, cooperation in the beginning. Maybe it's not my proud to say, I may be the first man in India who traveled and visited more than 250 to 300 museums all over the world. My capital, my investment is gone for travels, to study museum. Ultimately, it will benefits my country. That was the whole idea. Because those days, India could not afford to spend or invest money on these particular projects. Museum was not that attractive terms, we call it commercial. So, visitors are less, government don't have sufficient fund to do it. Maybe the people who sit in the hierarchy or in the top, they were also not that knowledgeable about this. So, again, I say, I constitute a foundation. The first award in this particular field, the people who contribute more than 30 years in the museum field, so we award the people from the country who credited, they contributed, they worked for it. Still it is going on. The first award in India who given for this particular field to any individuals, if I take it, the first conservationist of the country, Dr. Agarwal from Lucknow. That was the award given by Filippo's family. Now I have constituted a fund particularly for this, so that every year 3 people will be awarded. After that, first time since independence, government of India started recognizing museologists. Certainly, I am so happy and proud of it. Today, the country is in a very different phase. As our national leaders say that, we are very rich in population and resources, but we are still a poor country. We have more than 130 crores people now in India. Mind it, the youngsters have a big say about it. No country can afford to give you employment for each and everyone. You think that once you become qualified, don't go for that with that dream that government is going to offer you a job. So you have to find your own way. The experience you have to gain from others' resources. Your parents may have money or bank will lend you a loan. That is not a healthy practice. You have to start your basic training as a skilled man, as an apprentice on somebody's cost. Experience is very expensive. Always remember that. And in profession, when we sit across and discuss with you, always remember, common sense is not common among the commoners. So you have to create a special mark, benchmark out of it. What are you going to sell it? Unless you do not know what you are going to do it, you are going to end up in financial strain and you will ruin yourself. So don't take loan. Don't take your parents' wealth to mortgage. I advise you to every young estates, qualified or unqualified, try to study your skill. Get experience. You cannot have a fast buck very soon and become a successful businessman without having sufficient experience. I always tell, especially people who is in this profession. Fortunately, you got a degree as an architect or a civil engineer. So immediately what you do, you feel that I must start a business. I should practice it. You are a criminal. You have no experience. You are going to play with somebody's money and somebody's space. If you do a mistake, you say you kill somebody, you are assaulted somebody, there is a punishment that one time. But a poor man, he took a loan and bought a small property and hire you. You may have certain influence, you may be articulate. So you may grab the word. Who is the sufferer? The client. Your inexperience is going to make the life miserable for them. So it will bring curse to you. So I earnestly, very strongly, very honestly, from my heart I tell you, please my dear boys and girls, if you are architect or engineer, at least you should work for others for 5 years minimum so that you will understand the things. Something you read in the school, I know all the architectural colleges and engineering colleges, the lecturers are qualified, not very experienced. So ultimately the victim is the clients. Don't allow to do that. Be graceful and take blessings once the project is completed. you both will be happy, so that no one will wound up or end up in tragedy. Something I like to reveal, especially for youngsters who is going to start a business, especially who is related to a particular profession. He got three tasks in front of him, three worries. The first is a competition to get a project. Are you in the merit or not? How to get a project? Second thing comes is that once the project is awarded to you, the time frame when you can execute the work in time frame or not without a penalty. Once you cross these two, the third worry and sleepless night is really do they pay or not. So we have to go through sleepless nights. India is particularly, as a proud Indian, as a patriot, still I say that we have a very bad habit of delaying payment. Even you have money, purposely they delay the project. That quality we have to achieve. This is to be studied from abroad. Once they do the commitments, that will be always in writing. But what we do half the talk, half in writing, then we become friends and relations. So in profession, it never works. So to youngsters, my advice is that when you do everything, for anything, for anyone, kindly make it on documents. Make it in a write-up. Make an MOU. Make an agreement. So that you do not want a unwanted pain and you will not get sick the later period. So this I always earnestly say, anyone tell you in the beginning of a project, first question you should ask your client, ma'am, sir, what is your budget? The first answer you will get, you, it will bounce back to you, don't worry, money is not a problem. Finance is not a problem, you don't worry. That means that person is not going to pay you. The people don't have budget for it. Trust me, from my 50 years of experience, they will screw you and they will ruin you. Take it as a lesson.